Ahoy there, me hearties. Captain John Longcock here, press-ganging you into another Cyanex Pekka Mex on Radio Lewis, where the music matters. Arr.
Bye.
Good morning. You want to start mixing around the
Lewis, Willem? What a seamless start that was.
Seamless.
Sitting there, jigging away, and then 20 seconds before, realise you haven't got your kazoo at hand.
Didn't have your kazoo in my hand.
I've seen you move that quickly for a long time.
Well, not since last orders.
No, not since last orders. And here we are again.
Here we are.
Yes. And,
that was your waddy waddy.
I'll bring them back.
45 years ago, that was.
Well, they're still waddy waddy.
Clocks go back, so do we.
Well, we've decided we put our clocks back about 45 years, haven't we?
It's only half eight.
Yeah, I know. Honestly, we're amazing, so confused this morning. Why is it this hour confuses so many people? Why do we do this? It's madness, I tell
crazy.
You. I'm clapped out, and I just think, well, I've done so much, and it's a good job I did have an extra hour. But here we are, Sunday morning, recording the podcast for you.
Yes.
Aren't we diligent?
Yes,
yeah,
we
even
are.
Though it's school holidays.
Yep.
Shall I say it again? It's the school holidays. Oh, by Jiminy.
59 days to Christmas.
No.
It is.
I can't believe that.
We can start playing that. Christmas
59
music.
59 days.
Yep.
That's bonkers, isn't it?
Yep.
And, it's well in the air now. But although we've got, you know, pumpkins and all that malarkey to do, and just something when some people walk up the town with some bit of fire.
My Rose went to Ashford on Friday.
Did she?
With
what
Bradley
for?
To deliver something. Took a photo of a house that had all outside Christmas tree, all gone.
No.
Yeah, and inside, all the decorations were up.
59 days. That's
rock
good
and
work.
Roll.
That's good work. Oh, no, I can't
well
be
done.
Doing that yet.
Sarah won't
oh,
let me.
My days. No. Not yet. The old fairy light, maybe, just to, you know, herald the start of darkness, which is about to descend upon
us tonight.
Being bent
for the results show. Oh.
Don't
get me gaggle.
Swami Sai has had a prediction again, and you're not happy about the outcome, are you?
Rigged. The whole thing is rigged.
What, you mean a BBC employee?
Yeah, well,
who's a bit.
I've got to say, Mike was in the dance off with Catherine.
Yes.
And they saved the little weasel, Mike.
The weasel, Mike?
Yeah, that can't dance because he works for the BBC.
Do you think so?
Oh, yes. This is rigged.
Well,
that's it.
You know,
I'm not saying any more about it.
But you're still watching it.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so there you are. So they should care. Why should they care?
Have a ruffle on Saturday,
do you just think of all that money that they make off of that?
Poor little loves.
They must be going to, what, BBC?
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah. Any road.
Hey.
But that's your prediction, because, of course, this is being recorded on Sunday morning.
Yes,
so we have absolutely no merry clue.
I had a prediction that gave me the hump.
Yeah, it did. I opened the door. I'm having travelled here alone this morning, travelled by foot. And you flung the door open in disgust, didn't you?
In disgust, I was.
Yeah, yep. Disgusted of Lewis.
Because I was here early.
Yeah, you were.
Because the clock's going forward. I was here on time.
Very ambient it was when I arrived this morning. The tea and the coffees were already made.
Yeah.
And you had a little bit of Anthony Hancock. Have you been here 3 hours?
3 hours I've been here. Well, the clock's going forward.
No. Goodness
what's
sake.
Wrong with you?
No wonder you've got your lunch out.
Who?
Yeah.
I'll put that away.
Yeah.
Well, while I put it away, should we have a bit of slick?
Oh.
Don't let a lot become just a friend. Oh. together, let none tear apart. We give one another arm and a heart. My love, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, will love last forever? I know that it must.
Two there, count them two. The mighty Edison Lighthouse.
Honestly.
And Slick.
You're spoiling me this morning.
Well, one tries.
You are. And Slick. Very roller-esque.
Very roller-esque. And you can see that Bajur was already preparing for Vienna.
Oh.
On that.
Oh.
Oh.
Vienna.
Oh.
But I had a slight flashback then to our evening with Les McEwan.
Oh,
yeah, it was very roller-esque.
And
oh, those jeans.
They weren't his, were they?
Up close and personal. That, well, they were terrible, weren't they? Poor old Les.
What a quality evening that was.
He must be making a living, I suppose, somehow. Mind you, he didn't get off the ticket sales when we went
off
to see the Rollers.
Off the 60 that went there.
Oh, dear. What a night. What a night.
What a night.
And
quality.
Slick. Oh, my goodness. What year are we talking about? Early 70s?
1974.
74.
Yeah, 74.
Goodness gracious. Me. And it also makes me think of the posters that you used to get in the magazines, because I can remember Slick were real sort of...
Fab 208.
Yeah, he had that little sort of... Fab 208. Yeah, the little pencilled moustache, didn't he?
Ultrox.
Yeah, very, very thin. Yeah, bring it back, I'll say.
I might pencil one in over my beard.
Well, all the men are very airy at the moment, aren't they?
Airy?
Hair's back in, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
Hair is back in, apparently, all round.
Oh, is it?
All round. All I'm saying is...
Which is a bit of a worry for upstairs, downstairs.
With all this... Well, it is. Upstairs, downstairs.
The master barber.
Yeah, the master barber, I think, you know, upstairs and downstairs might not be doing such a roaring trade. As I understand, it is very, you know, in keeping with this ethical, authentic, I like that word, authentic, to have yourself... slightly less tamed, let's say.
Yes, less groomed.
Less groomed in the downstairs department.
Yep.
Yeah, so it's away with the vajazzles and out with the beads and plaits.
Out with beads and plaits. Nice.
Which has always been...
And the hair gel.
Side parting. But, yeah. Well, that's my understanding. You know, it's apparently the bush is back.
Got no Kate Bush on the list.
Yeah, Bush is back. She never went out of favour, as far as I'm concerned. I've always been a fan of Bush, as you know. But that's what I understand. If you were to watch these awful reality shows...
I might conduct a survey.
As I like to dip myself into a drop of Essex.
I might conduct a survey on Cliff Bridge.
But it's big news for these young girls, you know, and I think it's terrible that they've lived their lives.
Yeah. On the film Frozen, they were telling you to let it grow, weren't they?
And they were. Yeah, they were. Indeed. Yeah. Well, she obviously knew something, especially if it's frozen.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It's got to have something to keep the warmth, haven't you? It's very hooger. Yeah. So there
you
are.
A muff's quite good for the cold.
It is. Yeah. Are we hoping to be on air next week? I don't know. We might have to be going to bang on the door and plead with another radio station. Oh, no, they're only on for the next 2 weeks.
Oh, no, they're
not
stayers. I've already been asked this morning. Would you like to come up and produce a programme?
What'd you say?
Poke it up your nose.
Up your nose. Right.
I said, no, thank you.
Did you say?
Yes, I did. Yeah. My loyalty's here with my good listener.
Both of them.
Both of them.
Count them. Yeah.
Wow, count them.
Do you know what? Listeners did realise yesterday that last week that we actually did... Well, it is ethical to recycle. We recycled a show, didn't we?
I did make a mistake, though.
You did, because I was talking about me going to see Bohemian Rhapsody.
And we put that one out 3 times now.
Oh, it's always a winner.
A wizard on the end.
Oh,
what
did
world
it?
Did you want?
Well, it's in the build-up. But, you know, our avid listeners, both of them, did text me to say, what's happened? They said, what's the matter? And I said, CBA.
Yeah.
Basically. But it's good to recycle.
Yes.
Isn't it? You know,
yes,
like string bags. Although, yesterday, we were conducting a survey around the town about how much you can pay for a string bag.
Yeah.
You know, your proper common sort of string bag.
String bag, proper string.
Top of the town.
Yeah.
Well, that's not necessarily airy. Top of the town, I won't name names, one of the shops at the top of the town, nearly £8 for a string bag.
Really?
£8?
Really? It's not size sounds.
It's not size sounds. I think you should start buying string bags.
£8
for a string bag. Over the road, at another ethically sourced, slow-living shop, it was down to about £5.50. And I bought mine for about £2. But, you know, string bags, the price of them, would you credit it?
Well,
when there's things in the news this week that were sent to me by my cousin Shirl and my dear husband, Mr. Mark Williams of Just Williams Removals, about the plastic bag. Actually, you should be going for a plastic bag. Because apparently all of this, you know, the brown paper and all the bamboo It's just as bad. And if you look into the man that actually invented the plastic bag, he didn't make any money out of it because he wanted to make a bag that lasted for a very, very, very long time. So there you are. You wait. Give it 10 years. We'll all be back to plastic.
Yeah.
We will. But, we'll be back. You know, if you want to get a string bag, I would say go towards the bottom end of the town. Cheaper.
Yeah. Or get on a train and go to Brighton.
Yeah, no, you're going to pay the fare then, haven't you, Nana?
It'll still be cheaper.
Well, I suppose it would be cheaper. I bought mine in Spain and it was only £2. But
over,
it cost me a few hundred quid to get there. But, you know, that's it. Yeah, you, hey, what? Hey, carbon
what?
Footprint and all that sort of thing.
What about that? Right, yeah. Should we have another track?
Yeah, let's go back to the 70s.
Oh, records.
Will do.
Made it.
Well, you run away and stop. Why become so alone? Won't you run away and stop? Don't you let it die. Come on, go.
Elton John, Crocodile Rock, and then Motley Hoople with Roll Away the Stone.
Honestly,
from 1974.
You can't beat a shalalala push push.
No, you cannot indeed.
Rolling away stones.
Yep, yeah,
I'm hoping to roll away a few stones this weekend as I'll go to the Mind, Body and Spirit Festival.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. No, honestly, no. It is one of the highlights of my calendar.
Oh,
it is really.
Oh, Shirley not going then?
No, she's going to a beer festival.
Oh, well, yeah.
She said, no,
there.
Well, yeah, and I think that there used to be one a year, the Mind, Body and Spirit, but now they've snuck another one in now. But I should be going there to Smell to Get Well.
Oh, yeah.
Up the town hall. This Saturday coming, and I'll tell you what, I'm hoping that Alan and his gongs are going to be there.
I might come with you.
I've booked myself in for a gong bath.
Have you?
Yeah, we're all over. Oh, yeah. I love it. There's all the chairs all set out.
What?
And,
you sit in that and have a bath?
Yeah.
Was like a strip wash?
Yeah, proper, yeah. You know, yeah. Gentleman's wash, you know.
Oh, nice.
The one that you have on a cold morning or when you can't be bothered.
Oh, yeah.
You have it, you know, you immerse yourself in Alan and his gong. I'm hoping he's there. He wasn't there last time.
He's been rested.
Has he? Oh, no. assaulted by a didgeridoo. But yes, there was a, you know, you can immerse yourself in sound. That's what it is.
Oh.
So, yeah, it is. There was a lovely lady there last time. You know, you sit there. Stop it. Sit there and immerse yourself in sound as she walks amongst the crowd, shaking her maracas. And you're going, and all that sort of thing. And
what, you do that?
Yeah, no, honest to goodness, if you want to laugh, if you do want to laugh, it is, and I shouldn't. I do embrace these things. I do like to have a little sound bath, but I'll tell you what, if you want a good old giggle and all, get yourself to the Mind, Body and Spirit Festival. Yeah, you could do.
Yeah.
You could. We could immerse ourselves in size kazoos. Yeah.
Spit from my kazoo.
Have a wash at the same time. Oh, it's a spit shower, honestly. And you can get some nice bit of grub, you know, all ethical and all that, and authentic. And, you know, pay exorbitant amounts of money for people to rub you in with overpriced bits of goose fat and all that sort of thing.
A lot of them might not be there.
Why not?
They might all be protesting.
Eh?
They might all be protesting.
What, is there another one?
Well, there might be.
Oh, there might be somewhere, I expect.
There's bound to be, isn't there?
But, yeah, the one side of the hall... the town hall, you know, the main bit is where all the clairvoyants and the psychics and the card readers.
Yeah, they see you coming.
Yeah.
Close
due,
due
to unforeseen circumstances.
Yeah.
But they're all there with their tables set up, and you can go round and you can book yourself little slots, you see. I've never taken up with that, you know, when you go and visit your angel and all that sort of stuff. And I know, a bit half funny.
I might take crystal balls.
And you can have your bumps felt and all that sort of thing.
Hey.
The other side is more sort of trade stuff, you know, your crystals and your bits of hemp and, you know, smelly things.
What,
and yes, smelly goodwill. Essence of Nicholas Witchell, that's what I'm going there for. Yeah. But you can go there. I had my head massaged very nice last time. It was quite funny because I had my head massaged and very nice it was too. She gave me a right proper going over.
Did she really?
Yeah, and very nice it was too. Well, I walked away and I said, oh, thank you very much. Goodbye. I said to Shirley, who was with me, that was good, wasn't it? She gave me a right going home. She said, I didn't pay her. She'd slipped her a fiver. Yeah, she massaged me head. So you can get over there. You know, I've got my turban.
Oh, that's it. I could wear mine.
I reckon Swami Sai.
I could wear my fez.
Couldn't you?
And my cape.
Yeah, I reckon we could do it.
Take me crystal ball.
We could. Honestly, we so could. Sai, next pick and mix, Swami Sai. Yeah.
Us, Lord John. See, yeah.
And Mystic Nick.
Maybe a sponsor us to go there.
I think they should do. Because we are good at predicting futures, aren't we? You know. And, you know, there's a few old bits of stuff you'd be able to rake up. A bit of gravel from somewhere.
Seaweed hanging around.
Yeah, unravel an old shopping bag.
Not £5.50, I'm not unravelling it.
No. But you've got a week to prepare. Should I book you a table?
Oh, yes. Swami Sai
will fill your bumps.
Hello.
Yeah.
Let me fill your bumps.
And they're all certified.
Yeah, I bet
and
they
you
are.
You just think, where are you certified? Who certifies
these people? This bus turns up. It's a special bus. Yeah. And they just let them all out with their carers.
But, you know, they're making a living doing this. Are they?
No.
Do you think it's hobby stuff?
Just old hippies, aren't they?
They can't be making a living, can they?
To the job centre. Well, you want to be a clairvoyant.
Yeah. Well, you know, I don't know. Well, it's a bit like when you went there and tried to get a job as a shepherd, isn't it?
It was, yeah.
Yeah, that didn't pan out well, did it?
A toboggonist.
No, a toboggonist, yeah.
they thought
a tobacconist. Yeah. Oh, dear. Well, you know, if you want, it is an experience, let's say, and I can't wait. What a boon. All holiday, I'll be waiting for that. Got a few things booked up for the week ahead, you know, there's all the Halloween events and kids stuff.
Well, you haven't got to have the makeup on there,
shut up. This is me being authentic on a Sunday. Yeah, and it's scary. I'll show you my new hat in a minute.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, oh, I bought
is it a mask.
No, but it's very big.
Can you get shopping underneath it?
Well, I reckon I could get a bit of shopping in it. It's very large, but it's from the charity shop. So, it is recycled.
Yeah,
oh, honest to goodness, it is such a mega hat.
I bet it's that hat that we gave away this week.
No, I'll get it in my shopping trolley. Yeah, I'll go and get it.
Should we have a bit of cook-a-choo?
Yeah. Oh.
Really?
Alvin Stardust, choo choo choo.
Listen closely to that.
Let's groove on the mat.
Let's groove on the mat, yeah. But lie down on the mat and have a look at my choo choo choo.
Honestly,
all those years, you just groove along and you just listen close to it and you just think, what was he?
I've got more to come.
Oh, yeah, I'll bet you have. You haven't got any that you shouldn't be playing, have you?
No. I've been told. I was told by above me that I'm not allowed to because I did inquire.
Oh, did you? Yes, no. Oh, dear. Mr. Glitter is in his tube. And so rightfully he should be. But Alvin, I don't know. He's long past, hasn't he?
Yeah, about 3 or 4 years now.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Well, what Cuckoo was about.
Most of are dead.
Are they? Well, it was a long time ago, wasn't it?
Elton John's still. Yeah, he's alive still, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Phil Collins.
I have to say, it's very disconcerting talking to you while you've got my hat on. It doesn't look
and
quite the same.
And what did you say when I put it on? Why do I look like a tramp with your hat on? Very nice.
Oh, no, you know.
My Metallica Justice for All t-shirt.
I don't know whether you're allowed to say tramp anymore.
What do you mean you can't say tramp?
There aren't tramps anymore, are there? But you've got a look about you. Or, you know, like very village yokel.
Wurzel.
Something like that. My lovely tweed hat.
Hello,
and
my
actually,
darlings.
I hadn't realised when I bought it, when you've got it on, that it's quite threadbare. And I can see that without my glasses.
I can feel a draft on my ball patch.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh. No. Yeah. Oh, actually, no. It'll do.
That's making me itch.
Is it making you itch?
Yeah,
well, I must admit, I did buy it from the charity shop and put it straight on my head and wore it down the town.
My beautiful locks.
See, look, when I wear it, don't you think?
Paddington. Yeah.
Oh, it's a look of Paddington. Yeah. Although, Mr. Williams of Just Williams Removers said I look like Vera. You know, the investigator.
Oh, yeah, very nice.
Yeah. Brenda Bleflin. Brenda Bleflin. Yeah, that one. So, yeah, he might be off. She don't talk like that, does she? It's a YI man, isn't it? I can't watch Vera. It annoys the absolute life out of me. I know you do, but I just wish you'd take that stupid hat off. But now I'm sitting here wearing one. But never mind. What do you think of it? £3. That'd do me. I tell you, that's me for the winter. Although I have got I haven't got my new lovely red raincoat that I got from one of the charity shops up the top here. I wore it to work. And I have got to say, I belted it up. And somebody said, "You've got a new coat?" And I said, "Oh, yeah." I said, "From a charity shop?" And I said, "Yeah." And they said, "Thought so." I didn't know how to take that. I really didn't know how to take that.
You take that flashing.
Yeah. So, honestly, there's no need for it. You see, I am ethical. I am.
Bit like myself. You see my full-length leather coat there?
Yeah. You've had that for donkey's years, haven't you?
Yep.
Yeah, that's old, your coat,
isn't it?
And that
of an old German soldier.
Stop it. Hey, you've been watching World on Fire.
I have indeed.
It's Dunkirk tonight.
Did you see the ventriloquist dummy on it?
Yes, I did, and it was very creepy. And then
from the corner, Sarah went, "No."
No. You've got to think about it. That film that you sent me, though, of the ventriloquist dummy, there was CCTV footage of a ventriloquist dummy in a cabinet in somebody's home.
Yeah. That it was a museum.
Oh, it was a museum,
yeah,
was it?
Yeah, and the security cameras picked up on it.
And it started to move, didn't it?
Yeah, his eyes were blinking.
Yeah. Oh,
a bit scary.
Yeah, very, very scary. Yeah. Oh, they're very creepy. Why you would want one of those in your house, I don't know.
I've got to have a ventriloquist dummy.
Oh, no, I don't like it.
I can't find one.
But World on Fire, honestly, if you haven't been watching it, get yourself an iPlayer and purge yourself and have a big old sort of box set Arama because it is amazing, isn't it?
Very good, yes. It's very,
very, very good.
Very good.
Dunkirk. Tonight, and I would imagine, I'm thinking that maybe the next week could be the last one because it would coincide with Remembrance, wouldn't it? Which is obviously on the 11th.
And before that, we've got David Attenborough tonight.
Oh, it's the start of that. Well, I love those programmes, but it's the dog.
That poor little penguin.
I know, but the dog goes mad. Does your dog go mad when David Attenborough's on?
No, she sits and watches sheep on...
Yeah, but Reg goes berserk.
And she likes pigs.
But does she just sit and watch
them? She sits and watches, yeah.
No, my Reg goes absolutely ballistic. Bearing in mind, he doesn't. He's not built for speed. He's like a sack of coal punk.
He's built himself, really.
But anything, country file, horse racing, anything like that, he goes mad. So I don't know when we're going to be able to watch David Attenborough, but awe and wonder at its utmost, really, isn't it? He's going all the way around the world, isn't he? Yep. All around the world here. Don't have to get out of your armchair.
Yep.
That's my sort of travel, that is.
It is. That's my toe. We don't have to cut the tracks.
Shall we?
Let's squeeze another couple.
Okay.
Star man waiting in the sky.
Double Diamond. Mr. Bow is Star Man and the mighty Mr. Essex.
David Essex, don't start on him.
Start.
Honestly, what a boon he is. And just remember them all in their heyday.
Yep.
You know, every dog has the day, as I say. I'm sure, you know, he's probably still doing the rounds now, Dave.
Mr. Bow is a bit thinner now.
Oh, don't say that. Don't.
He's not dead.
No, he's not.
He's not.
Yeah, I was going to say, he's off round Asda with Elvis.
We've had a laugh.
Yeah, haven't we have a laugh? But, you know, not dead anywhere, really. They just live on. But,
I mean,
David Essex. Hello. David Essex is still alive, isn't he?
Oh, yes.
God love him. although I haven't seen him for quite a while. I'm sure he's still doing the rounds somewhere.
Yeah, he's better. And the homes, the old people's homes.
Yeah, and what a show.
Well, thank you very much. Still got a couple more for you. Shall I welcome in now?
Yeah, we were very, very settled in the 80s, weren't we? Entrenched.
I like to change it a little bit.
And you've slid back even further, haven't you?
I have.
Yeah.
And when we get to the 20s, I'm going to give up.
Oh, what? Charleston?
Why not? Oh, let's have a couple more, shall we?
Yeah, I'm really enjoying it.
I'm gonna make you mine. She's faster than most, and she lives on the coast. Uh-huh. She's faster than most, and she lives on the coast. Uh-huh. I'm a two-penny prince, and I give her hot love. Uh-huh.
Hello with New York Grove, and then T-Rex.
T-Rex.
Who's T-Rex?
That's his younger brother.
It's Chinese. He was T-Rex. That's T-Rex.
T-Rex, sure. Yeah.
With hot love.
Oh, very, very good. And we were just saying, you know, nobody does that sort of shoulder dance.
No.
You find yourself falling into it. Yeah. A bit like you're digging a road, you know, you just push one shoulder forward. And I was just saying to you, I've been watching some of the old Top of the Pops. It was Hot Chocolate.
Chocks.
Yeah, very, very good. BBC Four. All the hits of the Chocks. I say, they knocked them out.
They did, from 1970.
It was a two-layer box of Chocks, I tell you.
They're one of the only bands that had hits every year for about 20 years.
But then you just think, oh, yeah, There's another one. Oh, yeah, there's another one. An old Errol. But there was some based in the 70s when, you know, the Top of the Pops cameras were running people over when they're doing that shovel dance and jigging around, and there's people being run over by cameras. Bring it back, I say.
Yeah.
Run people over with cameras, especially if they're wearing a top hat or something.
Well, this is it, yeah.
You know, one of those party hats that they used to wear on Top of the Pops. I know, but bring them back. That's what I say. And, you know, it sort of winds us on something. You're promising me something big
this
for
is the, good. End.
The end.
This is the
You've
end.
Been building me up to this.
This is good.
The You've even done the washing up.
I went and did it because I don't
Yeah, I said, I'll wash these cups up.
Laugh,
so, it makes you laugh. Yeah. Oh, all right then.
Thank you very much for listening. It's been Simon X Pickwick on Radio Lewis, where the music matters.
Music.
If you want to complain or get in contact or request anything, just send an email to Radio Lewis and they'll pass it on.
Really?
It would be nice.
Nobody ever emails. Nobody ever writes.
So, or we could put, I don't know, I should get some sort of radio, size sounds.
Well, you could have a little post box out on the wall. Yeah, suggestions
no,
box.
No, I'm not going down that route again.
No, and I'm hoping you're going to start screwing that up, because there's going to be bangers in that box before long, aren't there?
Yeah, there's going to be bangers
in the box. Bangers up alleys. It's going to start.
Do you like a sausage?
Do you? Oh, what? Up your alley?
No.
But it is getting to that, unscheduled explosion time. But you were just saying?
They're going to try and stop it.
No.
They are, these rebellion people.
Why? Because of the air pollution.
Yep.
I was just saying to you that one of the big supermarkets has decided not to sell fireworks this year. I should think it's a health and safety nightmare selling fireworks. I wonder whether they make any money out of them. However, people will go in for their fireworks and their sausages and, you know, do their big shop. So it's going to be interesting. Some of the shops are stopping fireworks. And you've got a whiff.
Yeah.
No, you've just got a whiff. No, you've got a whiff of that there might be a bit of hoo-ha on
hoo-ha.
The big night for us in Lewis.
Yeah, there's the rebellion.
To do with...
The torches and the air pollution and all that malarkey.
Right. So, what, you mean the smog?
Yeah, the smog. Yeah. The big dank smog.
Well, there is dank smog and it stops rain, doesn't it? Normally, if it's on a wet night.
Personally, they do try and see it because it could be fun to watch.
Oh, stop it.
It could be hilarious.
I'll watch you. Then you'll never stop the bonfire.
No.
You never stop the bonfire.
No.
You know, and that's part of the sport, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, last year, there's always some fraction trying to stop it.
Yeah, there was one year they were going to blow the bridge was going to get blown up, wasn't it?
Yeah.
By the IRA.
Oh, yes, remember that. Yeah.
Remember that. Horses everywhere there was.
Yeah, there were. Yeah, that was a long, long time ago. But there's always been a ruck.
Yeah.
You know, it all goes with it, doesn't it?
I'll be at home.
I've got to feel sorry for, I don't know what happened, but it was fell bonfire last night, wasn't it? And oh my giddy days. God, that was wet. I did feel for them. It's such a big thing, isn't it? You know, woken up to it all year and there it was, chucking it down. But yeah, well, we shall see. We've got one or two more shows before that big day arrives. So
we will be back. We won't be taking any more holidays.
No, I know. But, you know, it's good to rest, isn't it? You know, and it's good to be back. And what a donking show.
Wow, thank you very much.
Marvellous. What are you getting, the bus?
I think I might get the bus.
I've got the trolley. I've got to go and do a bit of shopping, you know. And if I haven't got enough room in shopping, I'm going to put it in my hat.
Yeah, why not?
And I've got my string bag as well. So I'm just going to go off and have a bit of a tot.
Oh,
yeah, very nice
this
too.
This song that I'm going to leave you in your head.
All right. Oh, an earworm.
This one is Lovely Day.
Oh.
By Count Arthur Strong. Enjoy.
Oh, no.
Wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and and as always gonna be. Ahead of me seems impossible to face, when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Then I look at you and the world's all right with me. Come on, just one look at you and you know it's gonna be a lovely day. A lovely day. Well, the day that lies ahead of me seems impossible to face, when someone else instead of me always seems to know the way. Then I look at you and the world's alright with me. Come on, just one look at you and you know it's gonna be a lovely day. A lovely day. A lovely day. How was that from your point of view? It's just about perfect for me. Hello?
Sea dogs, it's time to set sail till next week. I've been Captain John Longcock. This has been Sire Nick's Pick a Mix on Radio Lewis, where the music matters. And remember, me scurvy dogs, keep your powder dry.